Alhamdulillah. Wassalatu wassalam. Ala Rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajmain. Amma abad. A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Afala yatadabbaruna al-Quran. Walau qana min indi ghayrillah. Labujadu fi ikhtilafan kaseera. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Sanurihim ayatina fil afaqi. Wa fi anfusihim. Hatta yatabayyana lahum annahu al-haq. Aw lam yakfi bi rabbika. أَنَّ وَلَا كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ رَبِّ شَلِي صَدْرِي وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَهْلُ الْأُقْدَةَ مِنْ لِسَانِي يَفْكَهُ كَوْلِي My respected elders and my dear brothers and sisters, I welcome all of you with the Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace, mercy and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of Almighty God, be on all of you. The topic of this evening's talk of mine is the Quran God's word? Many people have a misconception that Islam is a new religion that came into existence 1400 years ago, and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the founder of this religion. In fact, Islam is there since time immemorial, since man set foot on this earth. And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is not the founder of this religion, but he is the last and final messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of Almighty God, to whom was revealed the last and final message, the glorious Quran. All the messengers that came before the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, they were only sent for a particular group of people. And this message was supposed to be followed only by that group of people for a limited time period. Since all the other revelations were meant only for a particular group of people and was meant for a particular time period, the miracles performed by the earlier messengers, by the earlier prophets, for example, the parting of the sea, giving life to the dead, it satisfied the people of that time. But today, we cannot go back in time to examine these miracles, to verify these miracles. But Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he was not sent only for the Muslims or only for the Arabs. The glorious Quran says in Surah Anbiya, chapter number 21, verse number 107. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, that we have sent thee not but as a mercy to all the creatures, as a mercy to the whole of humanity, as a mercy to all the worlds. Since Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was not sent only for the Muslims and the Arabs, but he was sent for the whole of humanity, and he was the last messenger, the miracle that was given to him is not time-bound. The miracle that was given to him should satisfy the people at that time, even today, as well as till eternity. Since he is the last messenger, that's the reason the miracle given to him should satisfy and be examinable till eternity. Though Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he has done and performed hundreds of miracles, but he never emphasized them. And we Muslims, we mainly boast of his ultimate miracle, that is the glorious Quran, which is the last and final revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of Almighty God, to the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And it is a miracle of all times. It could satisfy the people of that time. It can even satisfy today until the last day. It could be verified and examined that time. It can even be verified today. And inshallah, it can be verified and examined even till the last day. That's the reason it is the miracle of miracles. As far as the Quran is concerned, Any human being who has the slightest knowledge of the Quran, irrespective whether he's a Muslim or non-Muslim, he will agree that the Quran was first recited by a man by the name of Muhammad, peace be upon him, who was born in the city of Arabia, that is Mecca. There is no difference of opinion amongst anyone who has the slightest knowledge of the Quran, irrespective whether he's a Muslim or non-Muslim. As far as the origin of this Quran is concerned, there can be various allegations, replies, right or wrong. All of them can be broadly classified into three categories. The first, that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he was consciously, subconsciously, or unconsciously the author of the Quran. The second category, the Quran was written by Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, who learnt it from other sources, or he copied or plagiarized from other religious scriptures. And the third category is that the Quran has got no human origin, no human source, and it is word by word the revelation from Almighty God. Any answers you have for the origin of the Quran can be broadly classified into these three categories. There can be 100 answers. All of them will fit in these three categories. Today, let us examine and let us verify the various answers given by different human beings.